Hi everyone, this is Deb Kim, a Canadian pro. Welcome to my channel. Why don't you take a moment and subscribe, and then you won't miss any new videos coming up. Today I want to share with you some tips about African cichlids. So please stay tuned. Over the years, I have had many species of fish. My favorite species is now and probably will always be African cichlids. Now, depending on the fish you decide to keep, that will dictate how difficult they will be to maintain. Tropical fish vary so much that even when you decide on a species, you may need to look within that species for compatibility. This is one reason I love African cichlids, especially the Mbuna. I would say, for as small as they are one of the more difficult fish to keep. The reason for this is that they are quite aggressive. Living in a hierarchy, they must have some aggression to survive. Rift Lake cichlids are far more aggressive than tropical community fish and cannot be kept in the same tank. In order to set up an aquarium of any fish, your first step is to equip yourself with knowledge. Do your due diligence in researching the fish you're interested in. Their requirements differ as much as they do in many cases. In my experience, the most aggressive of all Rift Lake cichlids are the erratus. I like to call them the devil fish. They are very difficult to keep without them killing other fish. To keep these, it's best to have one male and a few females to keep them entertained and spread out their aggression. Inevitably, they will kill. I have had them on occasion, as I do love their look and coloration, but I just find they are not worth the trouble they cause within a community. With so many Rift Lake cichlids to choose from, it's easy to fill an aquarium with cichlids that are less aggressive and will live together without killing. However, with cichlids, especially the Mbuna, you will never have a quiet, calm tank. Living within a hierarchy, there will be constant battles for position. Fighting usually includes injuries, so be prepared. You want to choose cichlids that share a similar level of aggression. One huge element that also will increase your community's success is keeping one fish per species and limiting the way they look, the same coloration and scale patterns. If they are noticeably different in looks, they don't perceive each other as much of a threat as if they look alike. The more distantly related they are, the less likely they will be to fight. A successful way of keeping cichlids is only keeping males and then only one of each species. Now the problem with this is Rift Lake cichlids are almost impossible to sex as juveniles, which is the size that you want. As they grow and learn about hierarchy, claim territories, and fight for position, you will need to watch and begin removing the lesser males to avoid serious fights and even death. Of course, there are other ways of dealing with aggression, such as rearranging your scape, thereby disrupting their territories. This will give them something new to think about and will lower the aggression. I do that weekly with this tank. Finally, a few tips on selecting healthy fish. Look for active fish. Cichlids are very curious and should come to the front of the tank to check you out. They have good vision and can see clearly through the glass of their tank. Healthy cichlids will be swimming at the lower level as long as it's not feeding time. Avoid fish that hover at the top of the water level. This is cause for concern, and more than likely the fish are either struggling or stressed out. You don't want any fish that look sluggish or have visible injuries like missing scales, bite marks, and so on. And finally, most importantly, you never buy a fish from an aquarium that has a dead fish in it. You don't know what it died from, and you could be transporting a serious sickness to your home fish. So no matter how beautiful they are, you're going to walk right by that tank. It's also suggested that you stock your tank with fish similar in size. In my experience, this is not an issue I have ever dealt with. You would think the smaller fish would be targeted, but I have found they are left alone more often than not. Now, I assume it's because they're not perceived as a threat, being so small and inconsequential to the hierarchy. However, if you have a fish attacking the small ones, you can bet you will be dealing with a bully in the future. When adding new fish to an established aquarium, it's best to add them in groups of no less than 4. Now, having said that, you must be careful not to add too many, as it could shock your filtration system with an overabundance of waste it's not prepared to deal with. This will help in spreading out any aggression towards the new fish. Trust me, cichlids are very alert and know immediately if there's an imposter in their midst. For this reason, I had new fish on water change day. There's so much going on, the water removal, scape changes, vacuuming, and everything else involved, they don't even care about the new fish. This gives the new additions a little time to check out their new home before becoming the attraction. Introducing new fish at this time, when new territories are formed, puts them on a more even footing with the other cichlids in the community. Your chance of success is multiplied. At this point, looking at this community, I am still not clear on who is my tank boss. They are all young adults and juveniles. The order of rank within the hierarchy isn't fully determined yet. I can sit and watch them for hours and see one being very dominant, and then a few hours later, I see someone else. Choosing to take on African Rift Lake cichlids is a decision that must be made, knowing that it will take some effort and commitment on your part. When you succeed in developing a healthy, smoothly run hierarchy, it's very exciting and rewarding. Just remember, it doesn't happen overnight. It also includes rehoming overly aggressive fish, and continued adjustments in stock. African cichlids are a challenge worthwhile.
So until next time, this is Deb Kim signing out. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you're having a great week. I hope your Friday's wonderful, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.